Hello, everybody. My controller's out of my hands. My headset's on. My mic's up here. If you're new to the channel, you probably don't know what that means, but if you've seen my videos before, you know that means it's time for a rant. Why? Because today is about the new released adult-only game on Steam called Hatred. Hatred puts you in the shoes, well, the top-down shoes, of someone who calls himself, well, his name is not important, literally and figuratively. His only goal, well, your only goal, is to kill as many simulated people as possible and die in the most violent way you can think of, or you create. Let's start this out by saying it's not modeled after real life events. It doesn't use the names of people, of real life people who have been killed or took part in any shootings. 3. It's rated adult only to keep kids out. Branching off of this, there was a game called Postal. That game got a sequel, and that game got a sequel, too. Postal 2 and 3, and 1, of course, had rampant racism, homophobia, and just general... Well, it was obviously for the shock value that the game was made. Purely to offend anyone who played it. Whether you pissed on a donut and made a cop eat it, used a cat as a silencer, suck on that one, Peter, or you did the unspeakable and did, well, anything else you can do in that game. Unless you're a bad parent, you're not going to buy such games for your kid. And if you're not a parent, or you're say 20, which I am, and you're just damaged, and you're gonna blow off some steam. No pun intended, Gabe Newell. They just fucking download the game and play it. You don't have to. No one's gonna force you to play it. No one's gonna take a gun to your head. Play it now. No. It is entirely your choice to download, no, to buy for $22 Canadian, 20, or I believe 18 euros and $20 US on Steam, Hatred. Download it and play it. Keep in mind, there have been worse games in the past. Custer. For example, that game is infamous, along with State of Emergency. And let's not leave out the, in my opinion, what is a gem of Manhunt and Manhunt 2. Both on the PlayStation 2 caused massive media scares and just a fucking shitstorm. But again, no one was forced to play it. It was so bad that the game was edited and the camera angles were edited as well to only have the sound of the death and not the actual image depicted. Now, if you got your hands on an unedited version, awesome. The game kicks ass. And you are most likely enjoying yourself, or you're off on some little blog trying to rant about how the game scarred your child because you were stupid enough to buy it for them, even though it was rated M. In fairness, Call of Duty, Black Ops, Black Ops 2, Modern Warfare 3, actually no, those games are rated teen, but no, some of them are. You probably lumped in the M rating with games like Call of Duty. these kinds of games branch out from that and almost meet the AO category, which stands for adult only. But if you load up Hatred and you or just the trailer and you watch the first 15 to 20 seconds of it, you know whether or not this game is going to offend you, whether or not you should buy it, and whether or not it's going to be appropriate for a kid. So, yeah. Also, if you follow me on Twitter, you've seen that in the past few days, I put in a tweet saying, actually, what? I'm going to let you guys read it. It's actually a great piece of subtle and basic yet of great wisdom and accuracy. Not to honk my own horn. You see it there. Violent video games are not dangerous. Only the people who take them seriously are. Yes, that is common sense. The only way a violent video game can be dangerous is if A, someone takes it seriously and they shoot up a theater, or B, they break the game in half and throw it at somebody. Now, unless you plan on breaking a $20 disc in half, or whatever the game costs, where you are, or what game you're playing, that's not going to happen. Unless you, and if you're that ill up here, you're probably on the verge of getting help, offing yourself, or you're most likely going to be getting help soon. In which case, neither of those things is a threat. Well, let me branch off a bit more here and say, not all gamers are shitty people. And not all shitty people are gamers. It's just like all jacuzzis are hot tubs, but not all hot tubs are jacuzzis. You see how that works? Kind of twisting around? Yeah. So before you, I don't know, badmouth some poor developer who worked his ass off make a very well done game, suggest you sit back, you steel yourself, you be quiet, and you think to yourself, is anyone forcing me to play this game? Is it going to offend me? The answer to the first question is no. If the answer to the second query is yes, then don't buy it. Don't buy it for your kids. Just don't buy it or play it. But if you're going to complain about it online, blogs, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, any of that crap, you're going to be giving creative destruction promotions. Advertising, you're basically going to be giving them sales, which isn't very smart. In which case, you might want to use this before you use this. Anywho, I hope that sparked some common sense in most people ranting about Hatred. I get it, it's very violent, But the restrict, but the ESRB restrictions are there for a reason. All right. So let's recap. There have been way worse games with lower ESRB ratings. Violent video games are not dangerous. Only the people who take them seriously are. And unless you're a shitty parent and you're going to buy the game for yourself or for your kid, or someone's putting a gun to your head, no one's forcing you or your child to play it. Otherwise, I think I'm done here. Hopefully this is sufficient enough to get people to stop complaining and just realize that that if it offends them, sure, just make a comment or so, or just say, oh, that's a bad game. Yeah, whatever. Okay. It is. In certain regards, yes, it is. But, like I said, no one's forcing you to play it. So, yep, we are done here, guys. So, if you agree, yes, this game is bad, but if you agree that people should not buy this for the kids, it's and that it's common sense to really just think about how it actually affects people in real life. It doesn't model after any public shootings in real life. It doesn't mention any names of real people. It doesn't have homophobia, racism, any of that crap. It just lets you blow off steam. If you realize this, and you're not on some little blog ranting about how this game is ruining my child, thank you for having common sense. If you're the opposite, please intellectually try and leave a comment down below, as I encourage all of you to do. If you're really hell bent on giving that game just a smack in the face and just trying to bring it down, it's not going to happen. But if you'd like to leave an argument below with some common sense, I would actually welcome that. That aside, I hope you guys enjoyed this rant. And feel free to come back and join me. Click the like or subscribe button below. And come on back to the edge of reality. See you guys.